بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وملاه. عيد مبارك to you all إن شاء الله. And welcome to the family night tonight إن شاء الله. We'll cover tonight the story, some of the stories and some of the lessons of the story of one of the 10 صحابة. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم give them glad tidings during their life they will be in Jannah. That Sahabi, his name is Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. He's actually from Mecca. He's not from Medina. And when we study Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, we have to look to the society of the Sahaba, either during Mecca time or Medina time, and we see how that society it was like what type of people or kind of people they were there. كل النماذج البشرية يعني all the types of people they were there. You see somebody very rich, somebody very poor, somebody you can say strong, somebody weak, somebody old, somebody young, somebody sick, somebody you know healthy, somebody he has a good family and tribe and so high you know nasab and his the what they call it, the family tree is very strong family. Somebody has kids, a lot of men around him and tribes, and somebody alone. This is Mecca, and even Medina time, but it was mostly at Mecca. Because most of the time of Mecca time, they were abid, slaves, you know? Exactly, doctor. So subhanAllah, let's see why you say that. Why you say that, why you mention that. After the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Medina, something happened like you feel it's like earthquake. You know, rajfa kbira. Yes, in Medina. But it was not really earthquake. Something happened. What happened is, Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha, the mother of the believers, she was sitting and she was listening and what's going on in the street. A lot of dust, big sound. They say, what is this? What is that? SubhanAllah. 700 camels, they came from Sham area, full loaded with stuff, trade, food, money, clothes, gold, whatever you can say, say. 700, 18-wheeler, nowadays I can say, 18-wheeler, loaded. And this 700 during the time camels being loaded completely. When that camels came to Medina, all the streets of Medina being locked. 700, you know, imagine that, loaded. Now, these camels, they are not going alone. You have guards, you have army, you have people around it. It's qafila, you know.
Caravan,
big caravan, huge, doctor. So you see the dust, you see the sound, and Aisha said, what is that? There is something wrong in Medina today. They said, no, this is Abdul Rahman ibn Auf caravan. It's coming from Sham. 700 camels being loaded, full. Allahu Akbar. Look how that man was so rich, radiallahu anhu arda. Aisha radiallahu anha, when she heard that, people coming to tell her, Abdul Rahman ibn Auf came with 700 loaded camels from Sham, full of, like, I would say camels and 18-wheeler, full of, loaded completely. And Aisha said, Amma inni sami'tu an-nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, aw nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yaqul, Ra'aytu Abdul Rahman ibn Auf yadkhulu al-jannata habwan. I heard Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, I saw Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, that Sahabi, entering Jannah like crawling like a baby. Crawling. And he's one of the great Sahaba, and already he knows. He knew from Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam while he was alive. He will be one of the people of Jannah. Yes, Rasulullah counted him. And subhanAllah, I will count his name. So she said, I heard Rasulullah saying that, Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, when he's going to enter Jannah, he will enter Jannah while he is crawling like a baby. Allahu Akbar. Why? Maybe somebody gonna say because he used to make a lot of bad deeds. No. He was one of the first people to enter Islam. He was with Rasulullah in the battle of Badr, Al-Khandaq, Uhud, and all the battles. He was with Rasulullah supporting Islam and the Muslims.
So like a
David,
like pure hearted?
He was striving. Striving while he was entering Jannah. It's not easy. What is the reason? Because of his money and his wealth.
Oh, fitness.
Yes, a doctor. Because of his, they think wealth is coming itself like this. You have to work hard for this wealth. Takes your time, your money, your effort, your time, your too many things. Because let me explain this. Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, this is the meaning of the hadith. He will not enter Jannah while he's running or jumping or rakdan
or
walking at least. Masalan. And they said Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, he migrated to Abyssinia twice. Allahu Akbar. People have migrated to Abyssinia, Al-Habasha once. He migrated twice. And then he migrated to Medina, to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yani he make three hijrah, migration. Wow. And he was number 8 entering Islam. Yani you can say, from the Sahaba and the kids and everybody, he was number 8 Muslim. Muslim number 8 in the earth. And he's gonna enter Al-Jannah while he was scrolling. He's scrolling? Migrated 3 times with Rasulullah and he entered Islam. He was number 8 person enter Islam, number 8 in the earth. Imagine that. And what else? Because of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he became Muslim, and he is one of the 10 Sahaba. Rasulullah count them in the hadith. They enter Jannah, and he gonna enter Jannah while he is scrolling. What did he do, jama'ah? And you think Rasulullah is lying? No, Rasulullah never lie. Rasulullah ma yantuq an al-hawa in huwa illa wahyun yuha. You know? Fasayyidina Abdul Rahman, when he heard that, subhanallah, taban as-sahaba, they take whatever Aisha radiallahu anha said and they deliver that message to Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. It is not an amima, slandering or backbiting, it's a knowledge. Something Rasulullah said it, and that man from Bab al-Amanat al-Ilm, they must advise him with the advice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, imagine that. If they heard that from him and he will do whatever he's doing. No, they said, no, Rasulullah said that about you. Man, wake up. Wake up. SubhanAllah. Now, is there any contradiction of what Rasulullah said? He's going to be one of the people of Jannah and the Sahaba. With the Sahaba, the great, one of the, number 8 in Islam, la ilaha illallah. And he's going to enter Jannah while he's scrolling. There is no contradiction at all. Why? There is a hadith here to explain that. When Aisha delivered that message, or somebody take that message to Sayyidina Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, and another narration, Abdul Rahman said, وَمَا عَلَيَّ إِن تَصَدَّقْتْ مِئَةً فِي الصَّبَاحِ فَيُؤْتِيَنَ اللَّهُ أَلْفًا فِي الْمَسَاءِ. What I have to do, when they told him, you're going to be crawling while you're entering Jannah because of your wealth. You have a lot of money. He said, what I have to do? If I make sadaqah with $100 in the morning, Allah give it to me 1,000 at the end of the day. What I have to do? I cannot reject this money. This is the work of Allah Azza wa Jal. Imagine that. He's giving sadaqah with $100. Yani, I give you example. In the 100 dirham, yani 100 dinar dirham. In the morning, Allah make it 1,000 for him at the end of the day. Allahu Akbar. What I have to do? He was telling them, Allah is the one who give me this money, you know? Subhanallah, this is very great message, jama'ah, to those who have money nowadays and they are collecting. Because I know personally, too many people they have, I can say, not million, billions of dollars, wallahi al-azim. I know them personally. I've been sitting with these people in their houses, with these people in their houses. I used to eat food with these people. I used to go, and I'm still going with this. Well, I live in California, in the United States of America. We're not living in our village there. Yes, I know, I see these people, I sit with them, billions of dollars. And they think because they are coming for Salat al-Fajr or Salat al-Isha, or they're giving some dollars in the box of the masjid or doing that, they think, khalas, they are in Jannah. They are in Jannah. This message, very strong message, brothers or the sisters who has money. Today you have to think like this. This is Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. And I just mentioned, who is Abdul Rahman ibn Auf? Number 8 in Islam. He migrated 3 times, two times to Abyssinia, one time with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, He was with Rasulullah in the battle of Uhud, Badr, Al-Khandaq, all the battles. He was with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He spent a lot of money. I'm going to mention it to you right now fi sabilillah. And look what Aisha is saying. But now there is no contradiction. He said, guys, what I have to do if I make sadaqah with $100 in the morning, Allah make it 1,000 for me at the end of the day. Allahu Akbar. Tayyib. We're going to solve the problem of Abdurrahman ibn Awf about this hadith. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, Ya ibn Awf, innaka min al-aghniya. Oh, son of Awf, Abdurrahman, you are one of the richest people.
Allah.
You are one of the richest people, Ya Abdurrahman. Wa innaka Ya Abdurrahman, ستدخل الجنة حبوا. You're going to enter الجنة while you're crawling, Ya Abdurrahman. فأقرض الله يطلق لك قدميك. Give for سبيل الله, في سبيل الله. Just give. Allah will release your foot. Which is mean now you are out of this problem now. More you give, and Abdurrahman got it already. يعني already Abdurrahman, he knows before Aisha رضي الله عنها told him that hadith, he knows what Rasulullah said about him.
He used to just give.
Yes. So he said, I see you entering Jannah crawling, but to be out of this problem, what? أقرض الله, just to give for the sake of Allah, Allah will release your foot. Imagine somebody like, remember Guantanamo? These people when they used to put iron in their foot and their hands, it was very difficult for them to run, even to walk like this. Allah will take this chain from your foot. Just Allah will release your foot in the day of judgment. Just give for fi sabilillah.
What's the message from God to him?
Exactly. Exactly. فالله سبحانه وتعالى said in the Quran, كلا, this is now, it's the nature of the people, the nature of the people now. كلا, of the insan, of the human, of the man. كلا, إن الإنسان لا يطغى أن رآه استغنى. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, nay, indeed, the insan transgressed. أن رآه استغنى. If you see himself became rich, rich in what? Knowledge, not money, not just money. People say rich means money. No, it's not just money. See somebody, subhanAllah, has some knowledge. Knowledge makes people also arrogant. Transgress, yeah. Knowledge is so dangerous. If that knowledge you did not gain benefit from it yourself, that knowledge can destroy you. That's why Rasulullah used to ask Allah and say, oh Allah, Allah, inni as'aluka 'ilman nafi'a. Oh Allah, I'm asking you for beneficent knowledge, you know. فهنا الإنسان بيطغى transgress when he became rich or he became knowledge, money, wealth, position, whatever you can say. فهنا سبحان الله يا جماعة عبد الرحمن بن عوف he understood now whatever رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم is telling him. Allah will release your foot when you give قرضة to Allah, when you lean Allah or give loan to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. سبق قرضة حسنة.
So God was giving him the money as a test for him, so he
of course
away.
Yes. نعم يا دكتور. فهنا والقول الشهير الذي ورد عن النبي, خذ من الدنيا ما شئت وخذ بقدرها هما, ومن أخذ من الدنيا فوق ما يكفيه أخذ من حتفه وهو لا يشعر. الله أكبر. ده أثر يعني, it's not حديث, أثر وارد. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, take from the dunya whatever you want وخذ بقدرها هما. Whatever you take from this dunya, this is هم, grief and sadness. And they said, and if you take from this dunya more than what you need, this is a burden in his shoulder. It's like a burden, something heavy load in your shoulder.
Burden.
It's a burden in your shoulder.
Yeah.
Yes. And this, subhanAllah, doctor, this is Allahu Akbar. And this is, subhanAllah, Allah, it's a load. Abdul Rahman ibn Awf, when he understood that, he knew the money now and the wealth is not his mission. It's a wasila, it's a mean to certain way, to certain mission. It's a mean to certain mission, which is he take that money and he use it for getting the mission. The mission is what? Allah and his Jannah. Because he get the message from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you, Abdul Rahman, you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to release your foot, and what you have to do? Just aqrid Allah, just give for the fi sabilillah. قال يا نفس إلا تقتلي تموتي هذا حمام الموت قد صليتي إن تفعلي فعلها رضيت وإن توليت فقد شقيتي. This is عبد الله بن رواحة when he said in the battle of مؤتة. يعني he said يا oh my نفس if you will not die you will be if you will not be killed you will die one day. ف don't worry about this dunya. يا جماعة الله سبحانه وتعالى said عند عبد الرحمن بن عوف الصحابة they understood that وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين. You have to hasten yourself, race with each others to Allah's forgiveness and then His Jannah. Why Allah said forgiveness before Jannah here? إلى مغفرة then وجنة after that. Thank you. That's it, doctor. Because if you will not be forgiven, you cannot enter Jannah. You have to be forgiven first. That's why Allah mentioned that forgiveness and maghfirah first, then He mentioned Jannah. So you have to hasten yourself to the forgiveness, to seek that forgiveness from Allah. Then if He give you, He grant you, He bestow you His forgiveness, you will be enter Jannah. And إِلَى جَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ It's with the samawat and the earth أُعِدَّتْ being prepared for the muttaqin, the pious and the mu'minin. So we have to understand that.
Assalamu alaikum.
So we have to understand that. Abdurrahman ibn Auf, he understood that issue. Some people, when you ask them for sadaqah, you think يعني, like you're killing them in their head like this. They think you're taking their ruh, their spirit, and their heart from their body. Yes, that's why Allah said, Al-mal wal-banun zina tafhata dun. Al-mal, the wealth, and the banun children is the zina of dunya. Adornment, ya doctor? Yes. Adornment of dunya. يا حزينة الدنيا والحاجة الدنيا فبيب الله بس ماني سماش بس عبد الرحمن بن عوف when he got the message and he knew Allah سبحانه وتعالى when he gonna give him money عبد الرحمن بن عوف سبحان الله if you see how when he imagine that somebody left his house three times he left مكة he went to Abyssinia طبعا if somebody migrating He's not taking his wife, family, mostly, or his wealth with him. Somebody's running away, fleeing with his deen, you know? He's leaving everything behind his back, just going alone like this. And he came back, and then he returned back to Abyssinia. Then he came back to Mecca, then he migrated to Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. When he went to Medina, he had zero money in his hand. Zero.
So why was he immigrating?
No, you look mustad'af. Mecca time people they were mustad'afin, they've been killed. They used to kill them in the streets. Yeah, farran bidini.
Torturing
because of that, yes. So let's see here, عبد الرحمن بن عوف وهو من أصحاب الشورى الستة الذين اختارهم سيدنا عمر من بعده كان محظوظ في التجارة جدا يعني طبعا شوف لك his superiority سيدنا عمر before his death he said six of the Sahaba they have to make consultation about who gonna be the أمير المؤمنين one of them عبد الرحمن بن عوف يعني maybe they can choose him. They can عبد الرحمن بن لكن عبد الرحمن هو الأمير خلاص. But سبحان الله they choose عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه وارضاه. ف when he migrated to مدينة عبد الرحمن بن عوف سبحان الله رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم you know he make brotherhood or brother مكة مهاجرين الأنصار he appointed certain people to be brother to certain people from مهاجرين الأنصار. And عبد الرحمن بن عوف كان نصيبه سيدنا سعد بن الربيع أو الربيع سعد بن الربيع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عبد الرحمن بن عوف from مكة سعد بن الربيع from مدينة your brother in Islam خلاص and سعد بن الربيع told him يا عبد الرحمن you are مهاجر you have no money you just came from مكة zero in your hand I have two gardens and two wives you choose the best of them if you choose the best of my wife I will divorce one for you I will divorce her for you. Gonna marry her. And look to the best of my gardens. I have two. The best of them, take it. And عبد الرحمن بن عوف, look what did he say? He said, I don't need any of yours. May Allah give you barakah. Just guide me where is the market. Businessman. Zero money. That's why 19 رزق في التجارة. يعني that's what رسول الله said. 19 لهم أدي يا دكتور. 90% of the risk in the tijara 90% of the risk in the tijara and عبد الرحمن بن عوف was a big businessman smart said no keep your wives keep your gardens جزاك الله خير just show me where is the market
because also the people of Mecca They were merchants.
Yes, that's right.
They don't know how to cultivate and
right.
And stuff like that.
Right. فهنا he said, لقد رأيتني لو رفعت حجرا لوجدت تحته فضة وذهب. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he made dua for him, for Abdul Rahman, with the you know, with the barakah in his business or tijara, and he started with some aqt. عارفين الاقط اللي هو ايه؟ dry cheese. ده بيقول عليه الان جميل في الاردن, اللي هو الاقط اللي هو dry cheese. They used to make cheese and they used to dry it and they used to sell it. He started with that. Nothing, you know. سبحان الله. فعبد الرحمن بن عوف, he said, والله لقد رأيتني, I saw myself, if I take a stone from its place and I look under that, I will find silver or gold. الله سبحانه وتعالى give him that baraka. سبحان الله. That's why I make صدقة with 100 دينار in the morning, Allah make it in the evening 1000 for me. الله أكبر يا جماعة. He said, they asked him once, how did you make your money, عبد الرحمن? How did you make your money? Very fast like that. And عبد الرحمن said, والله ما استقللت ربحا ولا بعت دينا. This is good for the business people now. If they are dealing with riba, usury, and they are in big disaster in their business, and people lost, they are losing their business because of this. Look at the businessman, what he's telling you. The real businessman. I think if Abdul Rahman ibn Auf nowadays, he will be one of the billionaires, and maybe the best, the first one in the earth. Allahu a'lam. Yes. Yeah. If during his time, 710 wheelers loaded, going to the Medina, during his time, this is now a big issue. And, أيوة سبحان الله. He said, والله ما استقللت ربحا. أيوة ما استقللت ربحا ولا بعت دينا. تجارة الدين ليست تجارة بل هي ذل وتسول وفقر وهم. يعني هاء وهاء ويد بيد, سلمني وسلمك وخلص وخلصنا. Yeah, I did not give anybody with dain, debt. I did not owe anybody money and nobody owes me money. ها سلمني وسلمك. Give me, I will give you. That's it. This is my business. That's why, mashallah, he make up his money. Management. That's it. Management nowadays they call it. Let's learn it from عبد الرحمن. ما فيش قشع. أيوة بالضبط. There is no greediness. أيوة بالضبط. Yeah. سبحان الله. عبد الرحمن بن عوف يا جماعة كان he was very example for us, for that person which is, he had a great manner and a good businessman, honesty. When he immigrated to Medina, like what I just mentioned the story now, he did not, if that happened to one of us now, Sa'd ibn Rabi' is telling me, say, Jum'a, I have two wives and two gardens, what do you think? I said, let me see them first. let me see them first, huh? He looked at his honesty, his akhlaq, his man. I said, may Allah give you barakah. Keep your stuff, I don't need it. Just show me the market, man. He was not greedy. And this is telling you how he's honest, subhanAllah. Businessman. That's why Rasulullah said, الصادق الأمين مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء. The honest businessman or businesswoman, he will be in the day of judgment with the prophets and the siddiqeen like Abu Bakr and the shuhada in their position in Jannah. Because he's ameen, he's trustworthy. Get me now out of 10. How many body trustworthy in his business nowadays? I see some business people, he's divorcing his wife 70 times a day. Because he's lying. Alay al-talaq min marati, this way. I swear by, I divorce my wife if I'm lying to you. 70 times divorcing his wife for his business. Lying, cheating. And nowadays, they said, if you cheat, you lie, you're going to make business. If you be honest, you're going to lose. This is what they think. But this is not right. This is not right. Let's learn from عبد الرحمن بن عوف رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. فلذلك يا جماعة, also, what they call it, to be satisfied, also it's good. Content or satisfaction. Yeah. يعني سبحان الله, رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم he say that اللهم من أحبني فاجعل رزقه كفافة. This author, يعني it's not hadith, but he said for those who are in love with me, those who love رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, may Allah give them content, make their رزق كفاف, satisfaction, satisfy them with that. Okay. عند فأكمل مستوى هو الكفاف لا غنى فيطغي هذا الغنى ولا فقر لا يحتمل. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم طبعا الكفاف means no poverty and no transgression transgression in the richness, you know, of wealth or something like that. كفاية. Okay, you don't need anybody, and at the same time you're not go beyond too much, you know, because that too much is extra load in your shoulder and you will be accountable for it in the day of judgment. Yes. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said هنا بادروا بالأعمال سبعة. Take advantage as much as you can from seven things before that another or other seven things is coming are coming. He said هل تنتظرون إلا فقرا منسية. Before, now you have money, you're satisfied. Before, maybe that can happen, you're gonna be poor instead of being rich, and that poverty will let you you became busy of looking for risk and the stuff like that, and you will not make your ibadah like before. For that's why if you are satisfied, you have some money, you're alhamdulillah, I say you're rich also, don't be lazy. Worship Allah as much as you can, because you don't know what can happen tomorrow. And out of this money too, try to make sadaqah, like Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. And he said, أو غنى مطغية. غنى مطغية. Okay, today I have money, tomorrow maybe I will be poor, and I don't have to have that. Today also I am satisfied, I have time to go to masjid, maybe tomorrow I will be rich, I will not come to the masjid anymore. You never know. فتيك ادفانتج اوف 5 بيفور 5 ذس وات رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سيد. ايوه او مرضا مفسدا اور ذات سيكنس اور ايلنس مفسدا ذات مرض. توداي يو هيلثي يو كان ميك قيام ليل تهجد يريد القران يو ميك تو ماني ثينجز بات ميبي تومورو اي ويل بي سيك اي ويل نوت بي ايبل تو ايفن تو ستاند فور ماي صلاه. فاتيك ادفانتج از ماتش از يو كان براي دو يور عباده بيفور ذات تايم از كامينج. او هرما مفندة. الهرم اللي هو not the pyramid. الهرم اللي هو being old. Now you're young. You're able to do too many things. You have capability. But tomorrow you're gonna be very old. And that هرم المفند you're gonna have Alzheimer and you're gonna have too much التفنيد اللي هو Alzheimer nowadays. Somebody خرفان الخرف. You know Alzheimer? You know if somebody get Alzheimer he don't know what he's doing. خلاص he's out. Is out بالمرة يعني. سبحان الله. I saw on YouTube I think that girl from Philippines or China, she old lady, her mom, she got Alzheimer. I think you saw this video. And سبحان الله, her daughter, she was very good يعني daughter. I wish my kids are gonna do with me like this if I became old يعني. Allah أعلم I died before or not. That سبحان الله, that her girl, she was washing her foot in the water, and سبحان الله, and she dry her foot like this with her body, and she's still kissing her, she starts kissing her foot, the foot of her mom. Old lady! And the lady, a doctor sent it to me. And that lady, what she did, she gets some money and she gave it to her, she thinks somebody working for her. And the girl started crying, you know, because she forgets, she doesn't know she's her daughter. Subhanallah. But the girl, she's so nice. She's washing the foot of her mother, cleaning, drying, and she started with her shaking, subhanAllah, face, drying her foot like this, kissing her foot. I said, this is Islam. This is birr al-walidain. Nowadays, when I say in the masjid, brothers, try in the morning and evening, give your hand to your kids to kiss it. I said, Sheikh, what are you saying like that? Some kharbanin doctors, I know them in Texas, Louisiana. Are you going to emulate our kids? I don't want to say anything because Allahumma la shamata rab. أنا مش عايز I don't want to record it here, maybe he's gonna be mad if I said it. اللهم لا شمع. I will tell you after the after I stop this. الله أكبر يا رب, الله أكبر. I told them, guys, listen to me, this is the way we grow up. In the morning you have to kiss the hand of your dad and your mom, and this out of respect. They grow up and they're gonna be 50 or more or less, and they're gonna kiss the head of their mom and dad. And now they said, Sheikh, you're asking us to humiliate our kids. No, this is the rights of the parents. Why are you going to humiliate your kids? The parents 24/7 working for them. Who is humiliating who? Subhanallah. Fa yani. Yes, sorry. Yes, yes, they are 27, Sheikh. And also, the Hadith said, also take advantage of your mountain mujhiza. You're still alive now. Maybe that mountain mujhiza, sudden death is coming, and you cannot delay it. If the death is coming, can you delay it? You cannot delay it. Mujhiz, يعني خلاص, finish. بغتة, sudden, yes. أو الدجال فشر غائب ينتظر. Or take advantage, this is for us. Before the coming of the Dajjal, the false Messiah, this is the worst fitna going to happen and people waiting for it. And do you think the Dajjal is not amongst us? We're looking around. We're in a masjid here. The Dajjal is amongst us in this world. The Dajjal exists. And all what you see from the killing, trials, fitna, what happened to especially to the Muslim because of him, the Dajjal preparing for all of that stuff. He's existing amongst us, not just this side. From the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all the prophets of Allah, they warned their own people from Dajjal, including Adam. Imagine that. And we are in the time of Dajjal. We are in the time of Dajjal. Dajjal exists. I prove that to you. That's why Rasulullah said in the Hadith, one of the major signs of the Day of Judgment, he did not say المسيح الدجال. No, he said ظهور المسيح الدجال, the appearance of المسيح الدجال. The appearance means he's there somewhere, he's hiding himself. But when everything will be ready for him, the earth will be ready for him, like, you know, when you cook the food is ready, he's gonna come, everything is ready, he's gonna do his mission, that's it, in 40 days, خلاص, you know. But everything he's behind everything, you know. عارف اللي بلعب العرايس بسموها يا دكتور
المابت شو.
Did you see the man is in the back? No, you see, and the man in the back making everything, you know, he's doing all of this, all of what you see, but he's in the back. الله مش زفتنا يا دكتور, ما هي دي زفتنا. This is the worst fitna in the before the day of judgment. Yeah. And they said أو الساعة after the Dajjal, or الساعة فالساعة أدهى وأمر. Take advantage before the day of judgment, because الساعة worse than the coming of the Dajjal. If the Dajjal gonna be bad, الساعة, the day of judgment gonna be worse than the Dajjal. So that's why Islam is telling you, don't let your wealth makes you busy and take you away from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Allah said in Surah Al-Munafiqun, verse number 9, last verse, يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تلهكم أموالكم ولا أولادكم عن ذكر الله ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون. Do not, O you who believe, O you who have believed, the ayah, يا مؤمنين, that's called to the مؤمنين, to the believers from Allah. He said لا تلهكم أموالكم, don't let your wealth and your money and your children taking you away astray from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you do that, you will be one of the losers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that. And Abdurrahman ibn Auf, what did he do? Abdurrahman ibn Auf, he donated all of these 700 full loaded camels fi sabilillah. Remember in the beginning when I said that? 718 wheelers been loaded, camels. Abdurrahman ibn Auf, he gave it fi sabilillah, to the Muslim Ummah, to the poor people. Not just that, I will tell you now. And he remembered that what Rasulullah said in the Sahih al-Bukhari hadith, Ta'is Abdul Dirham, this message today for the rich people amongst the Muslim Ummah. They are holding their kanz, their money. They are not benefiting people out of this. He said, Ta'is Abdul Dirham, Rasulullah making dua against these people, the slaves of Dirham, dollar, 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 dollar. You look to their eyes, you see dollar sign. Sah? Dollar sign in their eyes like this. They love dollars. That's why. Green eyes. Green eyes, yes, green eyes. That's why Rasulullah said, Ta'isa Abdul Dirham. May Allah make the life of the slave of the dirham miserable life. Salaam wa barakatuh. Ta'isa Abdul Dinar. Dirham al Dinar, yeah, and the small and big amount. Ta'isa Abdul Qatifa al Khamisa, that the silky clothes, that very rich. Do you see now in Beverly Hills, somebody said, Sheikh, I see a suit with $5,000 or more, right? Wallahi, Yakhra, for me, so much money.
Average.
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 Did you see the Indian man? He's making suit from gold. Gold, all the suit. Gold suit. I saw it in all suit. Subhanallah. That's Abdul Khamisa. In U'tiya radiya, in lam yu'ta lam yarda. If you give him, he will be happy. If not, he will be against you. Yes. طيب. سيدنا ابن عوف, let's learn from سيدنا عبد الرحمن ابن عوف. How he used to make sadaqah or infaq fi sabilillah to release himself from, to go to Jannah first. Not from, he will be in Jannah, inshallah. From that delay, like the sahab. بلغ من ساعة عطائه وعونه أنه يقال أهل المدينة جميعا شركاء لابن عوف في ماله. He used to share, give share to the all Medina people in his business. All the Medina, they have a share in the business of عبد الرحمن بن عوف. الله أكبر يا جماعة, والله إيه ده إيه ده إيه ده, سبحان الله. عبد الرحمن بن عوف, سيدنا عبد الرحمن بن عوف جاء له بطعام الإفطار وكان صائما, فولى فلما وقعت عيناه فقد شهيته وبكى. لماذا يبكي؟ They give him for, he was fasting. They give him iftar to eat. When he looked at the food, and he used to love that food so much, and he was fasting, and he started crying, and he did not eat. He stopped eating. They asked him, why you cry, Abdul Rahman? He said, Mus'ab ibn Umair, he was better than me. And when he died, they did not find coffin for him. They put izkhar, some kind of... above him, they used to cover his head, and his foot was shown. When they cover his foot, because he was tall, Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf, Mus'ab ibn Umair. When they used to cover his foot, his head was shown. His head covered, his foot was shown. And he was better than me, and I did not find, he was rich also, anything to cover him when he died. And Sayyidina Hamza, he was better than me. And I did not find anything also to put him as a coffin for him, Hamza, the uncle of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah giving us a lot, and maybe this is hasanat, Allah give it to us in dunya, we don't have anything for al-akhirah. That's why he started crying. Subhanallah. Ya jama'ah, this is Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. Let's see how he used to make sadaqah, radiallahu anhum. Ishtama'a ba'd al-sahaba yawman ala ta'amin indahu. Sahaba, he invited them for food. And he started crying also. They asked him, why you cry? Ya Aba Muhammad, his nickname was Aba Muhammad, the father of Muhammad. He said, لقد مات صلى الله عليه وسلم وما شبع هو وأهل بيته من خبز الشعير وما أرانا أننا أخرنا لما هو خير منا. He said, I saw Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم 3 months. He used to eat just dates and water. And he never satisfied from khubz al-sha'ir, very bad type of khubz. Sha'ir just for animal, they eat it. Subhanallah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf, ya jama'a, we have to know that استاذنا السيدة عائشة أن يدفن في حجرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم استدرك وقال أنا خليفة المسلمين ولعلها قبلت خجلا. ده سيدنا عمر. سيدنا عمر said that. Subhanallah. سيدنا عبد الرحمن بن عوف رضي الله عنه وارضاه, while he was dying, he was saying too many things. And رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, we have to learn from that. He said عبد الرحمن بن عوف in Jannah, in Jannah. And البشارة, that good glad tidings made him happy, because رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said he's gonna be in Jannah. And Allah said in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 262, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, those who are spending their money في سبيل الله, in the way of Allah, the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ثُمَّ لَا يُتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا مَنًّا وَلَا أَذَى, they are not hurting people because they are giving them that. They will get their reward. لَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ from Allah. وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. They will not be grieving in this dunya and hereafter. And they will be secured, inshallah. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Hadrat Sayyidina Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf also, subhanallah, I will mention something here. He was giving money from his money to the mothers of the believers. He gave a lot, really. Let me see. Okay. Let me see that. Okay. He spend money for the Sahaba and for the mothers of the believers. He used to give them a lot. And he spend a lot and he make his will before his death to give to many of the Sahaba, some of them, the mothers of the believers. He give them a lot from his money. So this is Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, jama'ah, today. And really, if you see somebody, you want to be jealous of him in the good way, not jealous in the bad way, jealous in the good way, just to compete with him or with her. And that good thing, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in that hadith, which is Imam al-Bukhari narrated, لا حسد إلا فثنتين. If you want to be jealous, means you compete with somebody in the good way. If somebody, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give him malan, فسلطه على هلكته في الحق. If somebody, Allah give him money, and he's spending a lot for the sake of Allah from his money. And he spend for its destruction, which means the money destruction in the right way. على هلكته, الهلكته يعني means the money itself. يعني الهاء عايد على الماني. هلكة الماني. And that man is spending his money, wasting, I cannot say wasting, في سبيل الله, in the حق way. That person, be jealous of him. Yes. And second person, Ya Rabbi, may Allah make us all, one of them, Allah give him wisdom or knowledge, and he will يقضي به ويعلمه للناس. Somebody Allah give him knowledge, and he's spreading that knowledge, and he's teaching people day and night. That person, compete with him and be jealous of him. Not jealous in the bad way. يعني be jealous of him, say, I wish if I gonna be with this person. I have money, yes, in the good way. I have money, I want to spend for the sake of Allah, or I have knowledge, let me spread that knowledge for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakum al-khair. Inshallah, if you have question,